All is looking good for the NASA and SpaceX Crew 5 mission, which is set to launch tomorrow at noon from Kennedy Space Center. The Falcon 9 rocket will carry an international crew of four people to the International Space Station. West 2 Scott Heidler is at KSC with a look ahead to the launch.
Dragon Crew Capsule Endurance atop a Falcon 9 rocket already on launch pad 39A will carry the crew of four to the ISS. For the first time, an indigenous woman from NASA will not only go into space, but Nicole Mann is the Crew 5 mission commander.
I'm here to tell you that we are ready to go to launch Crew 5.
The mix of emotions that you would expect.
Astronaut Nick Hague spent more than 200 days in space, two missions to the ISS.
I feel this connection with this crew, right? Because Nicole and Josh were both classmates of mine. Each of them individually, the Crew 5 members are amazing people. And they're embarking on their own personal first in many different ways.
NASA's Josh Casada will pilot the Dragon spacecraft carrying two mission specialists, Koichi Wakata from Japan and Russian cosmonaut Anna Kikina. She'll be the first Russian to ever fly with SpaceX, this amid heightened tensions between the U.S. and Russia over Ukraine.
The Russian cosmonaut is probably dealing with the issue of Ukraine the same way an American astronaut flying on a Soyuz to the International Space Station would deal with it, which is, we don't talk about that. We got more than enough to cover with just getting into space.
Hurricane Ian pushed the launch of Crew 5 back by 2 days, but the weather forecast now is looking very good. Launch managers are saying that they're tracking a few technical issues, but none are showstoppers. Soon after Crew 5 docks with the ISS, the astronauts will start their six-month jobs as scientists, working on experiments ranging from human organ production to fluid behavior and heart stem cell growth in microgravity. At the Kennedy Space Center, Scott Heidler, West 2 News.